Hello everyone. It's really important and hard to find the right tutorial from the first go that guides you step by step on how to model the ceilings properly. In this video, I will be covering all those things and will guide you on how to do things in the right way. So stay tuned and keep watching until the end of this video because I will be sharing great tips and tricks with you. Let's jump into the video. Before we dive into the ceilings, if you take a moment and subscribe to our channel, because we made an entire beginner series for you for free, you'll be able to follow that up from the pop-up link above or the link in the description below or above, depending on the platform you're watching. I highly encourage you to do that because it gives you a great value at no cost. So let's jump into the ceilings. In order to create ceiling plans, we need to go to the ceiling plan view first, and then click on the ceiling tool. So in the ceiling tool, if you go to properties palette, and if you drop it down, you will be able to see that there are two types of ceilings. One is basic ceiling, and the other one is compound ceiling. The difference between them is that the basic ceiling doesn't have a thickness. It is just a plane and contains a material. And the compound ceiling has actually a construction into it. So you can add different structural components attached to it, and as a final piece, as a finish, if you want to. They both work in the same way. If you just click a compound ceiling or generic ceiling, basic ceiling, so what you need to do is you can either sketch it or create automatic ceiling. If you do automatic, as you can see, there's a red boundary appears right around your screen, around your room enclosure. And this indicates that your ceiling will be created within those boundaries. So, however, it will obviously go all the way to the finish, not into the center, core center line or inside your wall structure. So if I click it just to do it, but just a simple click, and what happens is that my ceiling will appear right here. In order to choose it, I have to double click a tab. Obviously, when it's a basic ceiling, you will not be able to see it really and truly, like in, unless it has a material that is some kind of texture showing in the screen, you can visualize it in 3D. Otherwise, it's hard to visualize and almost impossible to see. So right now it's over here, as you can see in the 3D. And 2D, if I change it to the compound ceiling, obviously before that, I will just want to show you it doesn't contain any thickness, it's just a kind of plane. But if I change it to a compound ceiling, you can see that it also has a finish, a material that I can play with. And for some reason, if these grid lines, they're not matching perfectly to the, not aligning themselves to the face of the walls, you can simply go and click Align tool and click Align on the face and Align on the grid line, Align on the face and Align on the line, and then it will be aligning it. And obviously those will be cut and modified to, in order to fit. So it depends what kind of approach you want to take. If you want to take the middle approach, you can also go and have it on both sides and keep everything in the middle perfectly rectangular. So the next portion would be if we actually go, instead of doing automatic, what happens if we go and select sketch? It's basically going to be similar to the floors and roofs. So you just sketch a boundary. So if I go over here and select a compound ceiling and select a boundary, now in this case, I would go with this one if I want a little bit more different kind of approach. So if I want a bit of offset, so if I wish to go and pick line and I would like to have an offset of 4 inches, actually I'll go a bit more, 1 feet. And then I will just make sure that I pick the boundary. I can hold on one of my sketches and hit a couple of times tab, and it will be able to draw that kind of showcasing where your lines are going to appear. And I can click once, and now I can click finish, and obviously my boundary, my sketch will be appearing right there and then. Now I can go and do different heights of ceiling. So I can go to the next ceiling and I can do it a bit higher. And so I can just do, obviously, I can just pull it, maybe just do 7, 9, and then pull this and then do one more ceiling and do automatic and fit it into the sketch. And now you can see that I am actually able to play with different heights. Now I can put some LED lighting around it if I want to. So I can go with many different approaches, and I can just do this one.
generic ceiling if I want to, or obviously if you do like this in the sections, it will not appear good. So I would generally suggest you work with the thickness, you do work with the compound ceilings, unless you have to work with some kind of planes or you don't care about the sections. So the next thing we need to do is once we have the ceilings assigned to us, so in this case I will just click on the edit type, I will duplicate this, and you can see that I can just rename it and saying a generic compound ceiling. So I will over here, I will just keep default for now, that doesn't have any kind of texture on the surface, so which I don't want it to be intrude with my, you know, like appearance. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach some lighting components. So for the lighting components, I can use Autodesk library or I can use many other sources from the internet. One of the sources I suggest you to use, Bok Lighting. And this is a website where we, together with the manufacturer, I love manufacturers and suppliers who are into innovation because they are having a modular lighting component. So if you take into account how many components they have and how many modularity they can have, we came up this conclusion that we will have over 500,000 families to be made for this manufacturer. And that's a lot of time consuming workflow, and we need a lot of storage, database, and it's just waste of time. Instead, we went a different approach. We were actually doing a backend computation into it and connecting it with a forge. And forge is taking all the respective assemblies. So it's taking the fixture, it's taking the lamp, it's taking the mount, it's taking all any other accessories and combining it into a nested family, a mother family, so which you can also call super component, and it allows you to download that family. So I will be opening just one of them just to showcase you how it looks. I'm pulling it now, I'm upgrading it. So it looks like this. So this is just a test one. Basically, like if I go in 3D, I will be able to see that there's a IES file. There's a proper IES file, actually, the lighting source into it. And it has the fixture, mount, and everything. So it's gooseneck. I definitely suggest, if you're especially based in US, go and test these families because you will fall in love with them as an architect, because it's just so easy to make a lighting analysis. It's so easy to visualize all their components with a couple of clicks. And if you want to order them, you have all the database, you have all the components saved into your library in the website, so you can just order how many components you want and which components you're interested in. You can generate easily the schedule. So if I load it into the project, you'll be able to see that it is there, really well made. And obviously it's now it's saying minus, I can, if I go 8 feet, so let me do 6 feet. Okay, so I will most probably need to see where they're appearing. Okay, so they're appearing a little bit high. I will just go -2. Let me see, yeah, -1. Yeah, most probably over here now I will be able to visualize, not yet. And most probably my work plane is just cutting a little bit higher than I'm anticipating. But what we can see is over here is that if we simply turn off the elements, and in order to visualize it, how the lighting works, we need to go to lighting, and from here we can reduce the amount of sun and ambient lighting, maybe reduce a bit of the shadows. I need to make sure that I select the realistic, and from here I can go sun artificial only. I can get apply, and you will be able to see how sun and artificial lighting will work. Obviously, since I don't have a flooring here, and the lighting can penetrate. But if I just do artificial only, I'll be solely viewing artificial, no sun at all. Obviously, you might see a little bit, it's like as if it's too much powerful, the lighting. It's not the reality. When you zoom in, you can see that it is not reflecting that way. It's very soft lighting. In fact, this is for decoration purposes only. So but Revit makes you visualize like this because it's a realistic view. You will get the best out of it if you do lighting analysis or else a 3D rendering. You will get the most accurate response of your lighting. So just to confirm, the most accurate will be if you do the lighting analysis. Rendering still will give you a little bit different than the IES file performs because there are many other factors in the rendering and how it is being performed. Just to keep this in mind. So next thing to go to the ceiling plan and do some kind of input, some kind of ceiling components. So we will just go load family and we will pull up some lighting components from the Autodesk library. So I will just go lighting, I will just go architectural, internal, and I will pick up a linear box. And this linear box will be kind of a nice thing to visualize quickly. So here what we need to notice is that we cannot really snap. That's a little bit annoying part of Revit. It doesn't let you to snap with the lighting components. I try SI, snap intersection, it doesn't work. SE, snap end, it doesn't work. So what I need to do is a little bit randomly, I need to pull them in some locations like this, and I need to do manually align, AL, shortcut, which is represented also on the bottom left corner, and then align it like this. And that is a bit of annoying thing for me, but it's not the end of the world, so still you can perform it real quick. All in all, this is when you are done with the ceiling design, like putting the ceiling components, so you can come with another, you know, another ceiling component that is round in the middle, and maybe we can just offset it a little bit more, 6-7 feet from the ground floor. So I will go from the middle and I will pull it to 5 feet diameter. So now I will be able to see that real quickly in 3D. So over here, it is performing, it's going down. The reason I'm not able to see that is how my ceiling plan cut is being organized. So right now I'm going to go to the view range. I'll make sure that it cuts a little bit less. It goes 5 feet so I can see everything. Now it's much better. When I do this, I can do, I can just go ahead and put some walls here. So I will click on walls. I will make sure that I have some walls for finishes. So I will call it gypsum, 0.5 inch. I just want to confirm this. And gypsum wallboard. So once I'm done with this, I can go ahead and decline actually. And I will choose an offset of, maybe about 6 inches, and then I will hit tab to keep to select both a part of the arch, and it makes a circle. So once I'm done with the circle, I just want to make sure that the heights are, I had to do it before actually, but I hurried up a bit, so I will just move 7 feet to 8 feet. So actually, 1 second, I will go unconnected 1 feet. So that's what I'm going to do. It will start from 7 feet high and it will go 1 feet above that level. So if I go 3D now, I will be able to see my walls are there. I can simply select my walls, attach the top and base, I can select the base and make sure that I select the ceiling. I can do the same thing and attach the top to the part of the ceiling. So however, I might not be able to select now from the 3D. That's why it might be that I need to hide this part first, select them again, attach, and attach the ceiling. Now if I unhide it, I will be able to see the component. So then I will be just turning this into generic as well in order to have some design thing. I can pull some lights over here as well. Obviously you can do more and more stuff, but make sure that everything is neat and smooth in the tutorial. I don't have enough time to make all the time everything's perfect, so it's just giving you a guidance how to do and perform certain tasks. I hope this gave you quite a good insight. And before we finish, just let's take a look at the how lighting components are made of. So if you go to the book lighting one, as I said, if you visit their website, if you're especially located in the US, you should definitely try them. I highly encourage. And you can see that we have a proper lighting component here. And we can see that there is an IES file, photometric file, all the settings are properly made for their components. And then we have all the manufacturing components like perfect accuracy. So definitely check them out. You will fall in love with the quality. If you would like to learn more about the beginner tutorials, we have an entire series for you. So please check this one on the pop-up link above or a link in the description below. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, because every week we're publishing loads of Revit content and BIM related content for you. Don't forget to turn your notification bell on. See you next time.